Today we're going to use the awesome Tinkercad sketch revolve to make a train track, so let's get cracking. Friends, we will start with a bit.ly. Please type bit.ly/tink rail and press enter. Friends, this project is set to copy in Tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy in Tinker. So when you use copy in Tinker, you get an exact copy of my project. Note, this project was supplied by a user, Vernon. He asked me how to take this and make it so it would do a 90 degree turn. Now I do want to quickly highlight that ZDP189 did this from scratch. If you want to check this out, it is fantastic. You can ungroup it and learn from it. You can find it using a link in the description or the bit.ly up above. Tinkercad has recently blessed us with a brand new technique, though. It is called Sketch Revolve. I'm going to drop it right down here close to the tracks. Because of where I set it, we have got an awesome front view of those tracks. Now, this is the brand new Sketch Revolve. The first thing I want to highlight is right here. They give you all the features. This is a fantastic way to learn how Sketch works. You can also click here to learn more with the blog. They explain the pen tool, the edit tool, the actions, and how to add points. Of course, when you're done learning, you can simply move down here and click continue to sketch. You can come back to that at any time. Of course, if you enjoy my tutorials more, I will have a link up here in the corner, and also you can use the bit.ly to find all my tutorials. Our step right now is to use Sketch to trace one of these rails. I'm going to take the nudge and I'm going to set it to 0.1. That way I can get super close. And if you've got a different rail profile, this is where you would trace the one that you want. Now I can tell that this is the exact middle. I love that because I only have to make half of it. Keep it to the middle, come across, and then right here, this is the end of the straight lines. We want to now press number 2, which lets us do a bezier curve. We can click, hold, twist, and stretch the handles so it matches that same profile. I want to go back to number 1, which would be a straight line, and click right here. Now I'm going to go to number 2 mode, and I'm going to bend this just a little bit. Zoom it in so I can get as close as I want. I want to find a spot that's on the line, and then I can stretch and twist to get it as close as I can. Notice I bring it up, click and twist to get it the exact way I want. I'm going to twist it this way, and I'm going to bring it to this spot, and then I'm going to click straight across and finish it. Now to get this perfect, I'm going to double click. Notice it auto snapped. I'm going to do Control Z to undo that. And then I want to click on the points I want to mess with. Now I'm going to set my nudge to off. With that nudge set to off, I can click on a point and it moves by 1/100th. That is much more precise than we were using a moment ago. I can then click on these handles and adjust them. Notice they move together. I'm going to press number 3, which breaks the handles. You can see the dotted lines. And these let us move independently, so I can get that one perfect. Zoom out, I'm going to pan by pressing in my scroll wheel and get this so it fits exactly the way I want. Come down here and I'll double check this as well. Once again, these are smooth. If I hit number 3, they become broken lines, and then I can make them so that they match just a little better. When I'm happy, which I'm going to say this is good enough because I really don't have a train, so I don't know just how perfect we have to be. Let me show you the next step. Control C and Control V to make a copy. Let's take this one and mirror it. To do that, we just put a negative sign in front of the measurement. And then we can take the nudge. I'm going to set it back to 0.1. And I can nudge that part into place. That makes the single track. Looks like I need to come back one more so they overlap just like that. Now, if you're looking up here in the preview, that looks kind of weird. But wait till you see it when we're done. So right now I'm going to shift select those two, do Control C and Control V. It gives me an exact copy. If I do shift nudge, I can move them as a pair. Because I'm doing shift nudge, it is 10 times as much as if I was doing these single clicks. When you've got them lined up, once again, we can then hit finish sketch and I'll show you the odd version of our tracks. They're lined up the same as these tracks. They just spin in a circle. If we edit the sketch, are you ready for this? To make the whole project work the way you want, simply grab your tracks, change your nudge to something much larger. I'm going to go 5. And then if I shift nudge, there's 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 millimeters. When we hit finish sketch, we have all of a sudden got perfect tracks all the way outside going in a nice circle. Now, if you wanted to do a 90 degree turn or a 180 degree turn, you would just cut this in half. See this measurement? You'd make a block half that much and cut it off. Now, to make it so it's more smooth, simply make the sides max. To make the quality better, simply make the quality max. I'm going to change the color to gray real quick. And let's zoom in and take a look at our tracks. They are super smooth, and I think they would also be fun for SimLab projects. I'm going to move this to the middle of our world. Notice I did make the world quite a bit larger. And let's add the boards real quick. I'm going to reuse the boards that were here by doing Control D. Now I'm going to take this and I'm going to ungroup it. I'll get rid of the rail pieces. And these are already separate, so I can just grab one and put it over here. Grab another and put it over here. I'm going to just eyeball that to the middle and eyeball this to the middle. I think those are pretty close. Now I do want to hide these with Control H. And then we can grab all of this. Notice it says 3 shapes. Choose L for align. And I want to make sure I click on the rail. And I want to line them up this way. So now those two are exactly in the middle of each other. I can now shift select those two and do Control D. And I want to rotate those, I'm going to say 6 degrees, because I know 6 goes into 360. If you let go and don't touch anything else, you can do Control D all the way around your project. How cool is that? Once again, I do want to highlight this track created by Vernon. He was building it so they could snap together, and then you could make all sorts of tracks using these pieces. I do want to highlight that you'd have to add these connectors to whatever you built out here. I will show you once again. You can simply bring out a cube, and then you would just stretch it so it was large enough to cut this into a 1/2 or a 1/4 section. Once you added the ends, you should be good to go. I do want to highlight, I do not have a train, so I have not tested any of this. So let's do a quick wrap up. Once again, friends, we used the sketch tool, which is now also Sketch Revolve. We had the cool shape created by Vernon. I also showed you the sweet one by ZDP. It is brute force, but you really need to check it out. It is fantastic. And of course, you saw how Sketch Revolve can make the whole process ultra simple. I would like to take a moment to say thank you to everybody that's chosen a YouTube membership. Don't forget, there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody in my Patreon group. Love how that group is growing. Once again, thank you, Vernon, for the cool question. And of course, ZDP, thank you for sharing the awesome way to make the track. There is a sweet messaging area. You can all ask questions there. It is a great place to learn. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.